Transforming a nation of 90 million people is not an easy task, nor one done in isolation, but it is a unified action of the body of Christ. Ministering to those in government is a crucial component of nation transformation.
I have known Edsel Voso for some time through his books. And one of the books that that I have read is That None Should Perish. And when Pastor King Flores gave me a copy of that video on the transformation of the marketplace, particularly the transformation of the prisoners in almost jail in Argentina. If these hardened criminals were transformed by the Lord Jesus Christ, then we have hope in this government and this country that through the gospel of the Lord Jesus Christ, we can bring transformation in the government sector.
The nation of the Philippines, as we all know and have read in the papers, that even well-known newspapers and magazines like Time called our nation as the most corrupt nation in Asia. But this does not deter us from doing something for our nation, because we believe that transformation is purely a work of God, and with God, nothing is impossible.
God has opened a door of opportunity for us to share the gospel, the love of Christ, to top brass in the armed forces of the Philippines. God has used the Pull for Living Life book of Pastor Rick Warren as an entry point of sharing the gospel to the generals and senior officers of the armed forces of the Philippines. And because of that, many generals and senior officers in the armed forces of the Philippines have come to know the Lord Jesus Christ in their lives. And they in turn have shared that love to their soldiers.
And we are creating waves as far as the conduct of purpose-driven life among all 120,000 strong PNP personnel. We just use the purpose-driven life to plant the seed of faith in the hearts of every Philippine National Police personnel. And we hope to follow it up with spiritual lectures and eventually the conduct of Bible study in all the police stations all over the country. And we believe that in order for us to change our country, we have to institute reforms first in the police organization. And we are taking note of that that principle or that saying that we have to change our police force first before we can change our country.
The Philippines, in a sense, is a valley of dry bones. The church, the government, even the universities. This can be likened to a valley of dry bones. And the Lord is precisely raising new men and women with a new spirit, a new wineskin, a new sense of what the Lord wants for this nation.
From officials in government to ordinary citizens, God is on the move. Understanding that labor is worship empowers even the most humble of professions to play their role in the extension of God's kingdom.
Not long after I came to know Jesus, my Lord, He called me into the ministry. Without formal training, I just simply said, "Yes, Lord." In the place where God brought me, I have seen the power of God, witnessing that even a bar can become a church. The only strategy God taught me to implement was prayer evangelism. It was as simple as praying for the bar and the felt needs of the people working there. This leads us to introduce them to God. The homosexual floor manager was changed, and God's power was so evident all over that place that eventually the bar became a church. As of today, there are now 6 churches that have been planted after a year of pastoring in the area. To God be all the glory for His goodness.
God bless you.
I am an ex-floor manager of a certain nightclub, an ex-drug addict, an ex-pimp, and ex-sorcerer, and homosexual, and many other vices combined. But God in His goodness sent me one of His messengers. At first I thought he was a customer, and I liked him, but little did I know that he was one of God's workers, blessing and praying for me every time he came to the bar. With him around, I felt a hunger and thirst for the things of God, and that led me to receive Jesus as my Savior and Lord. From that day on, my addictions and vices were gradually removed. My heart was changed, and so was my homosexuality. I instantly forgot about my live-in partner, and God gave me a wife. Today, she works full-time with me, pastoring a church where I first came to know Jesus.
when we rebel against this government and demand the resignation of our president and our key leaders and our officers. That time, I thought that this was the right thing to do. I really want to change my country. I really want to change the armed forces of the Philippines for the better. But then, after that event, I was, by God's sovereign will, I was put into prison. And inside prison, that is where I really found out what God really wants for me to do to change this country. We must first change our heart for this country to change. And it's only through God and through Jesus Christ that our heart can be changed.
After asking for forgiveness, Jerry was pardoned, serving only 5 of a 50-year sentence, the first 3 in solitary confinement.
God led me to join the military ministry of the Campus Crusade for Christ, Southeast Asia. And now God is using me to change the heart of the officers and men of the Armed Forces of the Philippines, not through the violent means, not through act of rebellion, but through changing their hearts by sharing to them the love of Jesus Christ and the power of His death and resurrection.
The principles that Ed is teaching is very much practicable and even doable, especially in our nation, the Philippines. We've been doing and practicing these principles since 1997 that led for a bar to become a church, to a whole motel that was operated for prostitution, totally transformed, and even our city of Parañaque is also transformed. And now we're moving to a whole nation, the Philippines, to be transformed.
Building the church is what Jesus does. And every time God's children reach out with the love of Christ, we obey His command. And we continue to take the kingdom of God to the ends of the earth.